Dear students, good morning. In the last class, we had discussed some problems related to the finite series and some another problems related to the concepts of the binomial theorem. In this session, we are continuing the some other problems related to these concepts. Okay, let us start. Problem: if capital P and capital Q are the sum of the odd terms and even terms respectively in the expansion of x plus a whole to the power of n, then prove that these two results, first one is p square minus q square is equal to x square minus a square whole to the power of n, and second one is 4pq is equal to x plus a whole power 2n minus x minus a whole power 2n. So now we are to proving these two result. Here p and q are odd terms and even terms in the expansion of x plus a whole to the power of n. See the solution. What is the given expression? That is given that x plus a to the power of n. That is the binomial expression, x plus a to the power of n. Now we are writing this expansion. X plus a whole to the power of n. So what is the expansion? That is nc naught x to the power of n a power 0 plus nc1 x to the power of n minus 1 a power 1 plus nc2 x power n minus 2 a square and nc3 x power n minus 3 a cube, that is a cube, and so on, plus ncn x power 0 a to the power of n. So this is the binomial expansion of x plus a whole to the power of n. Here we have to given that p is the sum of the odd terms. So what are the odd terms? That is the first term is nc naught x power n a power 0, and this is the third term, and another this is fourth term, and so on. These are the odd terms, first term and third term and fifth term, and so on. Those are the terms, sum of the terms is given p. Here p is the terms nc naught x power n a power 0, nc2 x power n minus 2 a power 2, and so on. These are the terms. Okay, and q is the, what is the q? Q is the even terms. What are the even terms? That is second term and fourth term and sixth term, and so on. Now we are writing the even terms. That is nc1 x power n minus 1 a power 1 plus nc3 x power n minus 3 a power 3, and so on. These are the sum of the even terms and sum of the odd terms, that is p and q. Okay, now we have to write the sum of these two, that is p plus q. Now we are writing the sum of these two, that is p plus q. What is here p? P is nc naught x power n a power 0 plus nc2 x power n minus 2 a power 2, and so on. These are the sum of the terms of p. And what is q? Q is the terms nc1 x power n minus 1 a power 1, nc3 x power n minus 3 a power 3, and so on. These are the terms, sum of the terms p and sum of the terms q. Now we are writing sum of p and q. Now we are writing This is here nc naught x power n a power 0. Now this is the, we are taken the first term in the p, and next we are taken second term in q, that is the plus nc1 x power n minus 1 a power 1. Again we are writing nc2 x power n minus 2 a square. Now we are writing this term nc3 x power n minus 3 a power 3 and so on, plus last term ncn x power 0 a power n. This is the sum of all terms p and q, that is nothing but the expression of expansion, that is x plus a whole to the power of n. So now we are getting here p plus q, we are getting p plus q is x plus a whole to the power of n, that is same equation 1. Now we are writing p minus q. Now we are writing p minus q, that is what is the sum of the terms? P is nc naught x power n a power 0 plus nc2 x power n minus 2 a square plus so on, minus nc1 x power n minus 1 a power 1 plus nc3 x power n minus 3 a cube and so on. Now we are writing this is equal to, now we have taken nc0 x power n a power 0 in this three terms, and we are taken nc1 x power n minus 1 a power 1, that is the term in q, that is the minus nc1 x power n minus 1 a power 1. Next we are taken nc2 x power n minus 2 a square, and we are adding minus nc3 x power n minus 3 a cube and so on. Now we are getting that is ncn x power 0 a power n. Okay, that is the term. So that is we are getting here minus 1 to the power of n. Okay, so that is nothing but this x minus a whole to the power of n. So that is x minus a whole to the power of n. So here we are getting p minus q is x minus a whole to the power of n. Here we are getting p plus q is x plus a whole power n, and here we are getting p minus q is the x minus a whole to the power of n. These are the sum of the p and q. P plus q is x plus a whole power n, and difference of p and q, that is p minus q is x minus a whole to the power of n. Now we are to proving our given results, that is first one is p square minus q square, and second one is what is the value of 4pq. Okay, now we are to proving the given results. First one is we prove that, first one is we prove that, we prove that, that is p square minus q square is equal to x square minus a square whole power n. That is the first result. Here we are to proving this result. P square minus q square is equal to x plus x square minus a square whole to the power of n. Okay. Now right, we are writing here. This is now I prove that here first one is that is p square minus q square is equal to, that is x square minus a square whole to the power of n. That is we have to proving first result. Now we are consider, now we are consider what is p square minus q square. What is a square minus b square formula? A plus b into a minus b. Now we are writing this is p plus q into p minus q. What is p plus q? That is we are finding the result. P plus q is
x plus a whole power n. And what is p minus q? That is x minus a whole power n. Now the powers are same. Now we are writing this one is x plus a into x minus a whole to the power of n. That is nothing but this is x plus a into x minus a, that is x square minus a square, that is a plus b into a minus b form, that can be written as a square minus b square. So here we are getting x square minus a square whole to the power of n. Therefore our result is p square minus q square is equal to x square minus a square whole power n. That is we are proved. Okay, next one is what is the second one? What is the second one? Now the second one is we prove that what is we are to proving here? That is now here. Okay, now we are, the second one is we prove that what is here 4PQ is equal to, that is x plus a whole power 2n minus x minus a whole power 2n. X plus a whole power 2n minus x minus a whole power 2n. That is we are to proving here. Now we are take or consider 4PQ. Consider 4PQ. What is the value of 4PQ? We know the formula, that is the formula a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square is equal to 4ab. You know that the formula, that is here we are writing. So the formula is what is here, that is 4ab is equal to a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square. So this is the formula we are knowing that. So from that here we are taken here 4pq like ab, that can be written as now we are taken 4pq can be written as p plus q whole square minus p minus q whole square. So what is here p plus q? P plus q is x plus a whole to the power of n, x plus a whole to the power of n whole square. Okay, this is p plus q is x plus a whole power n, here whole square. Okay, next we are writing p minus q, that is x minus a whole power n whole square. Okay, so that is equal to here x plus a whole power n whole square, that is nothing but x plus a whole power n into 2, that is 2n, minus x minus a, here also n into 2, that is 2n. We are getting x plus a whole power 2n minus x minus a whole power 2n. Therefore we are proved here 4pq is equal to x plus a whole power 2n minus x minus a whole power 2n. So this is the second result we are the proving. P square minus q square is equal to x square minus a square whole power n, and 4pq is equal to x plus a whole power 2n minus x minus a whole power 2n. Here p and q are the sum of the odd terms and sum of the even terms respectively in the expansion of x plus a whole to the power of n. Then we are getting p square minus q square is x square minus a square whole power n, and 4pq is equal to x plus a whole power n minus x minus a whole power 2n. So that is 4pq is equal to x plus a whole power 2n minus x minus a whole power 2n. Okay, see the another problem. If the coefficients of 4 consecutive terms in the expansion of 1 plus x whole power n or a1, a2, a3, a4 respectively, then show that a1 by a1 plus a2 plus a3 by a3 plus a4 is equal to 2a2 by a2 plus a3. Now we have to proving this result. Here given that, see the solution. What is given here, given expression, given that the standard binomial expansion, that is 1 plus x whole to the power of n, that is the standard given expression, that can be written as in the sigma notation. We are writing in the sigma notation, here sigma, what is here, ncr x to the power of r, ncr x to the power of r. Now we are writing a1, a2, a3, a4 are 4 consecutive terms in this expansion. Then we have to show that the given result. Okay. Now we are taken later a1 is the coefficient of the term tr minus 1. Okay. Then we are taken, that is we are taken ncr minus 1. Okay, next we are taken a2 is the r plus 1th term. Rth term here, rth term coefficient ncr minus 1. Tr plus 1th term coefficient, that is ncr. And a3 is we are taken ncr plus 1. And a4 is we are taken ncr plus 2. These are the coefficients of 4 consecutive terms. That is here this is the trth term coefficient and this is tr plus 1 term coefficient, this is the tr plus 2th term coefficient, this is the tr plus 3 the term coefficient. Now we are taken 4 consecutive terms, coefficients are, we are taken a1, a2, a3. Now we have to prove the given result. Okay, take LHS of our proving result. Take LHS, that is what is here LHS, that is a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus a4, that is the LHS of our proving result. A1 by a1 plus a2 plus a3 by a3 plus a4. Now we have to find this value of LHS. Now we are writing a1, a2, a3, a4 values in that. Okay. What is a1? A1 is here ncr minus 1 by, what is a1 here? Ncr minus 1 plus what is a2? Ncr plus a3. What is a3? a3 is ncr plus 1 by, what is a4? Ncr plus 2. Okay, now we are writing this one is, we are dividing numerator and denominator by ncr minus 1. Then we are getting here 1 by 1 plus ncr by ncr by ncr minus 1. Ncr by ncr minus 1. Here also we are in the second term, we are dividing ncr plus 1 numerator and denominator. Then we are getting here a3 is ncr plus 1. Now we are writing this is 1 ncr plus 1 plus ncr plus 2. Here we are writing a3 is ncr plus 1, a3 is ncr plus 1 plus a4 is ncr plus 2. Okay, now we are dividing by ncr plus 1. Here we are getting 1 plus ncr plus 2 by ncr plus 1. Okay, that is okay. Next we are writing that LHS is equal to, that LHS is equal to, now we are writing this values 1 by what is here 1 plus ncr by ncr minus 1. What is the value here? N minus r plus 1 by r. This is the known formula, ncr by ncr minus 1 is n minus r plus 1 by r. Okay, next see in the second term we are writing 1 plus here ncr plus 2 by ncr plus 1. Here r is r plus 2. Now we are writing using the same formula, n minus r. R is here, r plus 2 plus 1 by r plus 2. Okay, that is equal to, here we are writing LCM. LCM is coming to the numerator. So r by r plus n minus r plus 1 plus here numerator, denominator, no, that is coming to the numerator r plus 2. Here r plus 2 plus n minus r minus 2 plus 1. Okay, that is here r by here minus r plus r is cancelled. We are getting n plus 1 plus here r plus 2 by here plus minus 2 plus 2 is cancelled and plus r minus r cancel. We are in that also we are getting n plus 1. So denominator is n plus 1 n plus 1. So numerator is we are getting r plus r, that is 2r plus 2 by n plus 1. So this is the LHS of our proving result. Now we have taken RHS. What is here RHS of our proving result? RHS is that is a2 by a2 plus a3. That is the RHS term. So now we are writing here that is equal to 2 into what is a2? A2 is NCR. NCR by a2 is NCR plus a3. A3 is NCR plus 1. Here also we are dividing NCR numerator and denominator. Then we are getting 2 by 1 plus NCR plus 1 by NCR plus 1 by NCR. Okay, that is equal to we are getting here 1 by 1 plus what is here the formula n minus here r is r plus 1 n minus r plus 1 by r. R is here r plus 1. Okay, this is c2. Okay, now this is numerator is 2 into r plus 1. So this denominator is coming to the numerator. So in denominator we are writing the LCM r plus 1 plus n minus r minus 1 plus 1. That is minus r plus r is cancelled. Plus 1 minus 1 is cancelled. We are getting 2 into r plus 1 by here n plus 1. That is nothing but 2r plus 2 by n plus 1. That is say equation 2. That is say equation 2. What is LHS value? What is LHS value? Is 2r plus 2 by n plus 1. Here also RHS value we are obtaining 2r plus 2 by n plus 1. From 1 and 2 we are writing from equation 1 and 2 LHS is equal to RHS. Okay, hence our result is okay. See the another problem. Prove that 2n c0 whole square minus 2n c1 whole square plus 2n c2 whole square minus 2n c3 whole square and so on. 2n c2 n whole square is equal to minus 1 power n into 2n c n. That is the proving result. Now we are see the solution. See the solution. Consider the expansions. Consider the expansions that is 1 plus x whole power n. That is the expansion of the standard binomial expansion. 1 plus x whole power 2n. We are taken 1 plus x whole power 2n. So what is their expansion? That is 2n c0 plus 2n c1 x plus 2n c2 x square and so on plus 2n c2n x to the power of 2n. So So say this is equation 1. So we are consider the expansion 1 plus x whole power 2n. And another expression, that is x minus 1 whole power 2n. X minus 1 whole power 2n. Now what is the expansion of this? That is 2n c naught x power 2n. Here first term is x and second term is minus 1. Then we are getting plus minus alternatively. That is 2n c1 x power 2n minus 1 plus 2n c2 x power 2n minus 2 2n minus 2 minus and so on. The last term is 2n c 2n x power 0, that is nothing but 1. X power, first term power is coming to 0 and second term is here 1. So that is equation 2. Okay, now we are producting these two equations. Now we are writing, product of these two equations. Now what is LHS? What is LHS? Product of these two terms, 1 plus x whole power 2n into x minus 1 whole power 2n. What is in the RHS? In the RHS we are writing product of these two terms, that is 2n c0, 2n c1 x, 2n c2 x square and so on, 2n c 2n x to the power of 2n into the second term expansion, that is 2n c0 x power 2n minus 2n c1 x power 2n minus 1 plus 2n c2 x power 2n minus 2 and so on plus 2n c 2n. So that is the same equation 3. So in that equation 3, the product of these two terms, so 1 plus x whole power 2n and x minus 1 whole power 2n. Now we are collecting in RHS of equation 3 the coefficient of x to the power of 2n. Now we are writing the coefficient of x to the power of 2n in RHS of equation 3. That is we are collecting in equation 3 in RHS, we are writing the coefficients of x to the power of 2n. What is the coefficient of x to the power of 2n? Now we are multiplying these two, 2n c naught, here 2n c naught. In the product we are getting x to the power of 2n. What is the coefficient here? 2n c naught, 2n c naught, that is 2n c naught whole square. In the next one is here 2n c1 x, here minus 2n c1 x power 2n minus 1. So now we are producting, we are getting x power 2n, that is the coefficient 2n c na c1 here minus 2n c1, that is we are getting minus 2n c1 whole square. Like that we are getting and so on. The last term is we are getting 2n c 2n whole square. That is the LHS of our proving result. Okay, so that is same equation 4. So that is the equation 4. So the coefficient of x to the power of 2n in RHS of the equation 3, we are getting the LHS of our proving result. Now we are taking LHS of equation 3. Now the coefficient of the LHS, we are adding LHS of equation 3. What is LHS here? That is 1 plus x whole power 2n into x minus 1 whole power 2n. So this is the powers are same. We are getting here x minus 1 into x plus 1, that is a plus b into a minus b, that is x square minus 1 a square minus b square, x square minus 1 square whole power 2n. That is the LHS of equation 3 is x square minus 1 whole power 2n. Now we are writing this is in the sigma notation form. In the sigma notation form we are writing 2n cr, here the first term x square whole power 2n minus r minus 1 to the power of r. That is the expansion of the LHS terms. Okay. So that is the 2n cr x square whole power 2n minus r minus 1 to the power of r. This can be written as sigma 2n cr x power 2 into 2n minus r, that is 4n minus 2r minus 1 to the power of r. Now we are collecting the coefficient of x to the power of 2n in LHS. Now we are writing the coefficient of x to the power of 2n in LHS. What is the coefficient of x to the power of 2n? So now for the coefficient of x to the power of 2n, now this power is becomes 2n. So now we are taken, this is power for the coefficient of x to the power of 2n, x to the power of 2n, we are equating this 4n minus 2r is equal to 2n. From that we are getting here 4n minus 2n, that is 2n is equal to 2r. For that r is equal to n. Okay. For the coefficient of x to the power of 2n, we are equating 4n minus 2r is 4n minus 2r is equal to 2n. From that we are getting r is equal to n. So in this expansion in LHS, what is the coefficient of x to the power of 2n? That is, we are taken, this is the coefficient. Okay, this is the coefficient. In that r is equal to n, we are taken r is equal to n. We are writing here, that is 2n c r is equal to n. So we are required the coefficient, that is here 2n c n. Here what is minus 1 to the power of r is nothing but n. We are taken r is equal to n, then we are getting x power 2n coefficient. So the coefficient of x to the power of 2n in LHS is 2n cn minus 1 to the power of n. So this is the equation 5. So what is the equation 4? 4 is the x to the power of 2n in the coefficient of x to the power of 2n in RHS of equation 3. What is equation 5? Equation 5 is the coefficient of x to the power of 2n in LHS of the equation 3. So now in that equation 3, the coefficient of x to the power of 2n in LHS and RHS are equal. Now we are equating the like terms on both sides. So from equation 4 and 5, from equation 4 and 5, we are getting the result. From equation 4 and 5, we are getting the result. What is the equation 4 is, that is 2n c naught whole square minus 2n c1 whole square plus 2n c2 whole square and so on, 2n c 2n whole square is equal to what we have to get here in equation 5, that is 2n c n minus 1 to the power of n. That is our proving result. Okay, this is the required result, that is 2n c naught whole square plus, so 2n c naught whole square minus 2n c1 whole square plus 2n c2 whole square and so on, 2n c 2n whole square is equal to, we are getting minus 1 power n into 2n cn. So this is the our required result. Okay, see the problem. Prove that c0 plus c1 into c1 plus c2 into c2 plus c3 and so on, cn minus 1 plus cn is equal to n plus 1 whole power n by n factorial into c0 into c1 into c2 and so on cn. That is the our proving result here. See the solution. So what is we are taken LHS. First we are taken LHS of our proving result. That is LHS is here c0 plus c1 into c1 plus c2 into c2 plus c3 and so on C n minus 1 plus C n, that is the LHS. Now we are writing this one is here. What is C naught? Where denoting simply C naught. Actually, that is n C naught. Now we are writing here n C naught plus n C 1. Here n C 1 plus n C 2. Here n C 2 plus n C 3 and so on. N C n minus 1 plus n C n. Now in each term we are common the first term. So here we are common the n C naught. Okay. Here common n C naught. We are getting 1 plus n C 1 by n C naught. Here common n C 1. We are getting 1 plus n C 2 by n C 1. Here common n C 2. Then we are getting 1 plus n c 3 by n c 2 and so on. Here we are common n c n minus 1. Then we are getting 1 plus 1 by what is here n c n, n c n. Here we are getting n c n by n c n minus 1, n c n minus 1. So that is we are getting. Now these are n c naught, n c 1, n c 2 and so on, n c n minus 1 writing the last. Then we are getting here n c 1 plus n c 1 by n c naught, 1 plus n c 2 by n c 1, 1 plus n c 3 by n c 2 and so on, 1 plus n c n by n c n minus 1. Now we are writing the remaining terms. N C naught, that is simply written C naught, N C 1 simply written C 1, C 2 and so on, C n minus 1. Now we are using the formula here N C 1 by N C naught, N C 2 by N C 1, N C 3 by N C 2. What is the formula? N C R by N C R minus 1, that is N minus R plus 1 by R. So using this formula, we are writing in each term, we are applying this formula. 1 plus here NCR by NCR minus 1, is R is 1, N minus 1 plus 1 by 1. Here we are writing N minus R plus 1 by R, here R is 2. Okay, and 1 plus N minus 3 plus 1 by, here we are writing 3 and so on. Here we are writing N minus N plus 1 by N. Here R is N. Okay. And into C naught, C 1, C 2 and so on, C N minus 1. Now we are observing here minus 1 plus 1 is cancelled. In that first term is N plus 1. Okay. In the second term here, that is 2 plus here N minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1 by 2. Next here 3 plus n minus 3 plus 1, that is minus 2 by 3. Okay. Next and so on. Here n plus n is cancelled. We are getting 1 by n into C naught, C 1, C 2 and so on, C n minus 1, and also we are writing C n. What is C n value is 1. We are producting with 1. There is no change. Okay. So this is the n plus 1 by 1. Here my 2 minus 1, that is here also n plus 1 by 2. Here 3 minus 2, that is 1, n plus 1 by 3 and so on. Here n plus 1 by n, n plus 1 by n into C naught, C 1, C 2 and so on, C n minus 1, C n. What is here in the numerator? N plus 1, n plus 1, n plus 1 and so on, n plus 1. How many times here appearing n plus 1? That is n times. That is we are getting here n plus 1 whole power n. In the denominator 1 into 2 into 3 into and so on n. That is the product of n natural numbers, that is n factorial. That is n factorial. In the remaining terms C naught, C 1, C 2 and so on, C n minus 1 into C n. That is we are getting n plus 1 whole power n by n factorial into C naught, C 1, C 2 and so on, C n. That is the RHS of, or is result. What is this? Is the RHS. Okay, so we are taken LHS, that is we are getting RHS. So this is the prod.